In previous class, so we are discussing transmission of heat. In transmission of heat, there are mainly three concepts are there. First one conduction, second one convection, third one radiation. Okay. So that is the first one. Conduction is going on, running. In conduction, the thermal conductor coefficient of thermal conductor is derived. And the formula also derived. So junction formula already derived. Now in conduction, remaining three concepts are there. Those are radial flow of heat, cylindrical flow of heat. The heat will be transferred. The heat will be transmitted. So as a radially, how those are moving. Those are transmitted as a radial. Again, how they are transmitted? Cylindrical. Now first one is radial flow of heat. See, see carefully. Consider a spherical body with inner radius r, small r. Outer radius r. This is the spherical body. The inner radius r is r1, outer radius is r2. Okay? Now, a heater which is placed at the center of two spherical bodies, a heater is placed. Which is placed at center of spherical body. The heater will transmit the heat from all directions. The heater will be transferred, will be transmit heat in all directions. That means in this one, the heater is situated here, the heater is present at center of spherical body. That means the heat also in this one, the heat also transmit from inner side to outer side as a spherical, like that. The heat will transfer as a spherical, like that. Spherically. Now, the inner temperature is T1, outer temperature is T2. What is the thermal conductivity? What is the thermal conductivity of the spherical body? Thermal conductivity. Now, we have placed a heater at the center of the spherical body. The heat will transmit from inner side to outer side as a spherically, because of the shape of the body is spherical. Now, the inner spherical body has temperature T1, outer becomes T2. Now, what we do finally? See carefully. From the same diagram, this is radius R1, this is radius R2. We know the formula. Q by T is equal to K A delta theta by delta X or delta R delta L. We know that. Here, Q by T nothing but H is equal to KA into dT by dR. This is R. dR also. dx also. Delta R, delta X also. Temperature difference by, already we know that, dT by dL, dT by dx. Temperature gradient. Already we discussed in previous class. Temperature gradient. See carefully, temperature gradient is always negative sign because of distance increases, temperature decreases. Distance increases, temperature decreases. Temperature gradient is always negative sign. This is negative. H means rate of flow of heat. Now, I will take one element of this diagram. One element. Between inner and outer. This is element. So that element has radius or thickness d r. That element has radius or thickness d r. This is t1, this is t2. Now we go for h is equal to minus a. A means 4 pi r square. What is the area of spherical body? 4 pi r square. What is the area of the element? Which is at a distance r from the center of thickness d r. We have to consider the element from center at a distance r thickness d r. Now the area of the element is 4 pi r square into d t. Okay. From this diagram, we separate the equation for our element with dr by r square, dr by r square. These two are transverse to it. What is the remaining? Minus 4 pi k by h into d. Integrate on both sides. Integrate on both sides. Integral 1 by r square dr minus 4 pi k by h integral d. Here temperature changes with respect to radius from center of the spherical body. See, temperature changes t1 up to t2, t1 dash, t2 dash, t1 double dash, like that. This is suppose here the heat is which is placed at center between highest body, highest point, that is hot body, this is cold body. So heat always comes from hot phase to cold phase. We know that. So the temperature gradient is changes with respect to temperature changes with respect to distance. Already discussed it. Now here distance decreases with respect to temperature. Decrease. There is a very limit size there. Decrease. Now what are the limits? R1 to R2. T1 to T2. Integral 1 by R square dr. Minus 1 by r. Minus 4 pi k of by h of t. T1. Yes. There is a minus sign is there. Suppose there is a plus 2, upper minus lower. There is a minus, lower minus. 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2 is equal to minus 4 pi k by h of t1 minus t2. R2 minus r1 by r1 r2 is equal to, see carefully, there is a minus. Now, sorry, this is t2 minus t2. Sorry, this is t2 minus t2. Upper minus. Now there is a minus. This minus is multiplied this way. Bracket. Finally we are getting 4 pi k by h of t1 minus. We want k. K is equal to h of r2 minus r1. Again what we are getting? K is equal to by 4 pi of r1 r2 of t1. This is a radial flow of the heat will be transferred from one place to another place, that is by the condition. Now in the heater is which is situated, which is present, which is placed center of the into spherical bodies. That means the heat will be transferred from center to outside as a radial flow of spherical flow of radial flow of heat as spherical. Spherical flow of it, radial flow of it, both of them. Radial, that is heat transfer will be as a radial, not lengthwise. Now, we know the formula, h is equal to q by t, nothing but power, radial power, heat power, or h, that is denoted by q by t, or p, or h, minus k, dA by dt. After A, now I take one element, or center, between R and R. I take one element, that is the distance r from center and the thickness of the element is dr. I substituted k is equal to a is equal to 4 pi r square. After we getting k is equal from the same one, what is the H value. K is equal to 4 pi K of 4 pi K R1 R2 K of K1 minus K2. Right? See carefully. Here, T1 is much less greater than T2. Always, because of the heater which is placed at center. So, at the heater place point, the temperature is more compared to outer side. So, this is the final what we know. Okay, that is radial flow of heat, spherical flow of heat also. Yes. Now we go for cylindrical flow of heat. That means a heater, a hot body, which is placed at the spherical, or that is cylindrical body, at center of cylindrical. Then the heat will transfer from one place to another place as so, which is the present of location, which is depending on the present of location. Suppose the body which is placed is that is a cubical body. The heat will transfer as cubical faces, spherical body, spherical faces, cylindrical body, cylindrical faces, like that. The heat always transferred from one place to another place as a face. Already we know that. Area of faces. Cuboid is proportional to area of faces. Now, we go for this is a cylindrical body. Okay, let us adjust the diagram. Okay, now this is the inner radius R1, outer radius R2, of length is L. Let us consider a small element. That element has a distance small r of thickness dr. This is R2. This is R2. Outer radius is R2. This is the element R. What is the area of the element? Cylindrical body. 2 pi R n. We know the formula. H is equal to minus K dT by dr. Here in the place of K, suppose the area is 2 pi r, this is the dr. Element also taken as same n, dr. Suppose 2 pi x r dx. We are taking the same n. Now, h is equal to minus k 2 pi r l dt by dr. So, dr by r is equal to dr, this two are minus k 2 pi l by h. Integrate on both sides, 1 by r dr minus k 2 phi m by h dp, t1 to t2 r1. Integrate 1 by r dr power, exponential r. Minus k 2 pi l by h of t2 minus t1. This minus is multiplied by that rocket, we get t1 minus t2. Log r2 minus log r1. K 2 phi l T1 minus T. Log R2 by R1. K 2 pi L by H. T1 minus T. We want K and also H. K. H log R2 by R1. 2 phi L. This is the concept which is related to spherical capacitor, cylindrical capacitor. So that is repeated again in your first second year. In second year, the concept, same concept is repeated as capacitor. In capacitor, cylindrical capacitor, cap, parallel capacitor. So that is spherical capacitor. This is also so related, same related, cylindrical capacitor. From this same one, H is equal to 2 phi K L of T1 minus T2 by H, sorry, log R2. Okay. Now we go for another concept. There is a small formula is there because of, so in mid level in 2017, one problem is asking in mid level that is related to this is the same problem. Formation of ice on the free surface of ponds. In cold countries, in winter season, ponds and lakes and seas are freezing at the night time. That is already well known, all are well known about that concept because of, so in cold countries the temperature is falls below zero, that means negative, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Formation of ice layer on the free surface of the pond. Suppose this is a pond having a water like that. Water, generally, the water at 0 degrees centigrade. Yes. Suppose in the night time, in the night time cold countries, the temperature falls, decreases below 0 degrees centigrade. Initially, what is the temperature? T1 is equal to 0 degrees. Finally, that is the temperature decreases to minus T. Minus temperature falls. That means the upper surface, the free surface, means upper surface, becomes freezing, becomes ice. Suppose, initially, the ice layer of thickness x1 at time t1, time t1. The thickness of the free surface of the ice at a time t1. After some time, the temperature again falls. So that is 0 to minus 10. Suppose 0 degrees centigrade to minus 10 degrees centigrade. Thickness x1, time t. Thickness. Again, minus 10 degrees centigrade to minus 20 degrees centigrade. Time taken, T2, thickness. That means thickness becomes increases with respect to time. Time increases, thickness also increases. That means the whole pond, whole lake, nearly 90% of lake, maybe 90% of ponds becomes freezing. The thickness is more, thickness is huge. That means total ponds and lakes, nearly those are formation, those are freezing, those are becomes ice. one, suppose 1 centimeter. From 0 to minus 10 degree centigrade, time is given. Sir, for 1 hour or 2 hours. After that, minus 10 to minus 20 degree centigrade after 2 hours. Time T, 2. Thickness becomes, thickness increases. Increases. What is the relation between time and thickness? Only we have a relation. We don't need derivation. Just remember, only one form. So there is a derivation also there. But we don't need the derivation. Only we have to remember one formula, one single formula. Only one formula. What is that formula? Now, what I am saying? The formula. First one, write out after this one. Right. By using this concept, what is the time taken to form the ice layer? So from thickness x1 to x2 or y1 to y2, that is your choice. You should take any one. So x1, x2 or y1, y2. So don't take t1, t2 because of here t is there. T is the temperature that is related to time. Now let us see time taken. To form. To increase. Thickness. From. X1. Is. Delta T. Rho L by 2KT of x2 square minus x. Just remember the formula. We don't need derivation. Because there is a derivation, but we don't need. So that is the formula related. Time taken to increase the thickness from x1 to x2. Rho L by 2KT, what is rho? Density of rice. L, later D of S. K, thermal conductivity of S. T, temperature. Next one, initial thickness. H2, final thickness. Finally, what we want? What is the relation? See carefully. Delta T proportional to x2 square minus x1. By using this formula, there is a one problem is there in quantitative level. What is that? I told you. Simple problem. The formation of the thickness of ice layer x1 is equal to 1 centimeter to x2 is equal to 2 centimeter. Time is delta t1 is equal to, so that is 2 hours. The thickness x1 dash is equal to 2 centimeter to x2 dash is equal to 4 centimeter. What is delta T2? He's asking in minutes. Minutes? We know the formula. Delta T proportional to x2 square minus x1 square. Delta T1 by delta T2 is equal to x2 square minus x1 square. x2 dash square minus x1 dash. That is the formula what we want. 2 hours by delta t don't know. x2 square. So that is 2 square minus 1 square by 4 square minus 2 square. 4 minus 1 by 16 minus 4. 4 minus 1 by 16 minus 4. 1.
3 by 2.
2 by delta t2 is equal to 3 by 12. 4. Delta t2 is equal to 8 hours. Carefully. So there is a time gap is more. So to increase the thickness, here thickness 1 to 2. Here thickness 2 to 4. Now thickness gap is 1 centimeter, here thickness gap is 2 centimeter. So for 1 centimeter thickness we are getting 2 hours. For 2 centimeter thickness we are getting 8 hours. 8 hours, see, there is a increasing of time for linear increase of thickness. Linear increase of thickness. So this is a 2017. Now, in the same manner, suppose x1 is equal to 1 centimeter 2, x2 is equal to 2 centimeter, delta t1 is equal to 2 ohms. x1 dash is equal to 2 centimeter to x2 dash is equal to 3 centimeter. What is delta t? See carefully. Now, why I am saying here that thickness is same, difference 1 to 2, 2 to 3. Time 2 hours, first one. What is the time? So, the time t2 is, delta t2 is equal to delta t1 or less than or greater than. Let us see. Delta t1 by delta t2 is equal to x2 square minus x1 square. x2 dash square, x1 dash square. x2 square, 2 square minus 1 square by 3 square minus 2 square. So 3 by 9 minus 4, 5. So 2 by delta t2 is equal to 3 by 5. What do you get? Delta t2 is equal to 10 by 3. 10 by 3 means 3.33 hours. See carefully. See, observe. Now time, the thickness is 1 centimeter. Time is 2 hours. Here also thickness 2 to 3, 1 centimeter, but time gap is 4 compared to shape. This is 2 hours, this is 3.33. That is the relation what we want. We must remember the relation. Now we go for conduction is completed, successfully completed. All the concepts are completed. Now we go for second one is convection. Convection. The process of transmission of heat. From one place to another place. In the medium. Medium must ensure. For convection, medium must. If there is no medium, there is no transmission of heat. Medium must. The process of transmission of heat from one place to another place in the medium with the actual movement of the particles. In conduction, there is no movement of the actual movement of the particles. There is no movement of the particles. The particle will exchange, only exchange the energy from one particle to another particle. Exchange. But in this one, the particles will carry the energy from one place to another. convection. Okay, convection, okay. How? It is explained with an experiment. Let us say, there is one vessel is there. The vessel containing water molecules. Under the vessel, we place the stove with burning stove. Okay? Initially, the molecules under the bottom of the vessel absorb the heat energy and becomes lesser density. After absorbing the energy, becomes lesser density. Density is important. Becomes lesser density, those are going to top. Lesser density means, so weight loss. Those are moving to, those are moves up to top. At the top of the highest density molecule are moves down. Here, the molecules, lesser molecules moves upward, higher density molecules are moving downward. This process will continue up to the total vessel becomes equilibrium. Here, the energy, heat energy absorbing the molecules which are constituted at the bottom of the vessel, which are moving from bottom to top. That means those are in the process, those are moving in the actual movement of the particles. The energy will carry the actual movement of the particles. Here, not exchange, only those are moving actual movement of the particles. And so that they carry energy from one place to another place by itself, by self. See carefully. Here, these are the molecules, denser molecules, less denser. That means the molecules which are constituted at the bottom of the vessel, which are absorbing the heat energy. Okay. Because of those are nearer to heat energy. Fine. Becomes less density. Those are moving upward direction. Those are moving, moves like that. Because lesser density, due to less density. At the top of the layer, having molecules have more density, which are moving downward because of higher density. This is happening. This is continuous up to the whole vessel becomes equilibrium temperature. ఇది కంటిన్యూగా పోతూనే ఉంటుంది. సో కింద ఉన్న మాలిక్యూల్స్ పైకి వెళ్తూ ఉంటాయి, పైకి ఉన్న మాలిక్యూల్స్ కిందకి వస్తూ ఉంటాయి. దిస్ ఇస్ ద యాక్చువల్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాసెస్ ఆఫ్ యాక్చువల్ మూవ్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ ది పార్టికల్స్ విత్ క్యారీ ద ఎనర్జీ ఫ్రమ్ వన్ ప్లేస్ టు అనదర్ ప్లేస్ ఈస్ ద బెస్ట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఆఫ్ కన్వెక్షన్. బెస్ట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద కన్వెక్షన్. ఇన్ కన్వెక్షన్ దేర్ ఆర్ టూ ప్రాసెస్. వాట్ ఆర్ దోస్? Natural convection. Second one, third one, forced convection. Natural. So the fluid particles, the fluid, actual fluid particles will carry the energy from one place to another place by naturally, without force, without external force, without external agent. That is called natural convection. The best example is, suppose the ventilators are situated in the room at the top, below the ceiling, just below the ceiling. So in the room, in the hot day, so during summer, in the room, the air becomes more, absorbs more energy, becomes hot. Those are moving up because less density, and those are escape from the ventilators. Less density air and warm air escape from ventilators, and at the same time, cool and denser air are entered into the room through windows and doors, which are presented at lower height to the room. So natural convection. రూమ్ లో హాట్ సమ్మర్ లో రూమ్ లో మనం వెంటిలేటర్స్ ఉంటాయి, విచ్ ఆర్ సిచ్యుయేటెడ్ జస్ట్ బిలో ద సీలింగ్, విచ్ ఆర్ ప్రెజెంటెడ్ అట్ ద టాప్ ఆఫ్ ది రూమ్ జస్ట్ బిలో ద సీలింగ్. దెన్ ద హాట్ ఎయిర్ ఆర్ ఎస్కేప్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద వెంటిలేటర్, కూల్ అండ్ లెస్ దట్ ఈస్ denser air entering into the room from windows and doors. That is by the natural convection. By the natural convection. Okay. Next, what is the forced convection? Suppose the hot air will not able to escape from the ventilators. Now we are doing some work. That means the hot air will send out through some machinery agents, machinery parts. Those are fan. Those are cooling agents. Those are pump. Those are AC, air coolers. So those are forced convection. The hot air is moving with naturally, with by itself, natural. The hot air will send out by force. Forced convection. Simple. Now, the hot air in room will escape from ventilators and cool denser. Sorry to say this. First, we write the definition. The fluid particles transmit heat from one place to another place with naturally is called the full particles, nothing but so carry the particles, carry the particles, energy carry just the particles. The full particles transmit the heat from one place to another with natural heat. That is called example. The hot air will escape from ventilators and cool denser air enter into from doors and windows. Is the process of next. So the fluid particles transmit heat from one place to another place with force, with external force. Example, pump, heat pump. Fan, air blower. Next, fourth one. Coefficient of convection. What is the coefficient? What is the coefficient of convection? K. What is the coefficient of convection? H. The heat will transfer Q by T. The heat will transfer from one place to another place per unit time. Is directly proportional to area. Is directly proportional to temperature difference. Only the heat transfer depends on only area and temperature difference only. Only. So this is A, this is delta. Now, what is that? Q by T proportional to A delta theta. Q by T is P proportional to A delta theta. What is QP? Energy by depth, heat energy by depth, heat power. P is equal to H A delta. What is H? Convection coefficient. Which is equal to P by A. Watt per meter square Kelvin. Dimension formula. M L square cancel T power minus 3 K power minus. Convection is also completed. Convection is just one phenomenon. There is no application to solve the problems. That is the one phenomenon. That is the one process to transform the heat from one place to another. So this is the convection. So this is the types of convection. This is the coefficient of convection. Come on. Ready. In transmission of heat, last concept is radiation. For conduction, medium necessary. Convection, medium necessary. Radiation, medium not necessary. So for radiation, the heat transfer from one place to another place, there is no need for medium. There is no need medium. Last one is radiation. The process of heat transmit from one place to another place without you. Example, best example, sunlight to reach earth. From sun to earth, there is a large distance. And from sun and earth, there is different layers with different medium. Some distance, there is no medium, but heat will be transferred. Heat will be transferred. There is no medium, but heat will be transferred. The process of heat transfer from one place to another place without medium. Is called radiation. Okay, now see what is the condition for radiation? Radiation nothing but energy. Energy. Suppose the sunlight is incident on the objects on the earth surface. the earth surface with all the objects, chair, board, so and human beings, that is all are objects for sunlight. The sunlight which is incident on all objects on the earth surface. Some of the objects are absorbing, some of the objects are reflecting, some of the objects are transmitting, some of the objects are all conditions are obeying. So depending on their properties, let us say, this is the body, this is the energy, Q. The energy is incident on the body. The energy is 100% from sunlight. In sunlight, 100%, some of the energy is absorbing. Some of the absorbed light energy is reflecting. Some of the energy is transmitting. That means Q, the energy. That means Q. 100%. According to law of conservation of energy, the total energy is distributed to three parts. Rad. That 100% is sharing rad. That rad, radiation, reflection, absorption, transmission. What is R? Reflection. Absorption. Transmission. All are not equal. Those absorption, transmission, reflection are so depending on the properties of the body. Body property in the absorption, reflection, transmission on the main. Suppose for black body. For black body, reflection 0, transmission 0, absorption is 100%. For another body. So reflection is 10%, absorption or 80%. Transmission times, that is depending. Next, applications. Q is equal to R plus A plus Q. 1 is equal to R by Q plus A by Q plus A by Q. R is equal to, 1 is equal to small r, small a, small a. What is small r? Capital R by Q. Reflectance. Small capital D will be transmittance. Okay, so we'll go for cases. Small r plus small a plus small d. 1. Okay, that is the relation. Now we go for first one. If R is equal to 0, A plus P is equal to 1, there is no reflection. Case 2. If R plus R comma T is equal to 0, A is equal to 100% absorption. Which body? In universal there is no 100% absorption of the body. But 96% of absorbing power energy, radiation. That is called black body. We know that in summer, don't wear black shirt. Don't wear cotton, black shirt and black pant. We are always wearing cotton shirt. Why? Because of during summer, the black body absorbing 100% of energy sunlight which is incident. which is incident on the black shirt, that is absorbing 100% of energy. That is not comfortable for wearing. That is not comfortable. So, in summer days, we are wearing white and cotton shorts. Because of white is reflected, not a perfect reflected, that is reflected. Which is incident on the white shirt, light is incident on the white shirt. Which is nearly, so that is 60 to 70% reflected. There is no effect. So that's why, so during summer days, the white painting is white. So at the top layer of the room or buildings, because of white is perfect reflector. So A comma D is equal to 0, R is equal to 100%. Perfect reflector. A is equal to R is equal to 0, T is equal to 100%. Perfect transmitter.
I am saying what is that
the main difference is small e capital is there is no difference, but so in our book is capital. So I also denominated in the same manner of a book, so that is capital. This is MSC 20. Right?
Another demo. 56.